Kangana under fire once again. First urges center to bring farm laws back.
किसानों के हितकारी लॉस वापस आने चाहिए और किसानों को खुद इसकी डिमांड करनी चाहिए और ताकि हमारे किसान भी जैसे बाकी जगहों पे समृद्धि हो रही है हमारे किसान की समृद्धि में कोई ब्रेक ना लगे.
Then makes a U-turn, apologizes.
किसी को डिसअपॉइंट किया है मुझे खेद रहेगा. आई टेक माई वर्ड्स बैक. थैंक यू.
स्टार एमपी एम्बैरेसेस बीजेपी अगेन. कांग्रेस फायर्स मेंटली अनस्टेबल जाई.
मेरे को लगता है वो मानसिक रूप से वो परेशान है, मानसिक बीमार है कंगना.
इज कंगना बीजेपी प्रॉब्लम क्वीन? टॉप फोकस ऑन फाइट लाइन.
Well, the BJP's Himachal MP Kangana Ranaut is learning the hard way that an outspoken actor celebrity doesn't always make a smart politician, and most definitely not during election time. Well, Kangana Ranaut has landed herself for the third time in a soup on the same issue, the farm laws issue. She said the farm laws should be brought back, triggering an unusual and instant chup karo wave from BJP leaders one after the other. They're all very sensitive right now because of the Haryana election coming up, the whole Punjab issue in general, and therefore Kangana Ranaut has once again been pulled up and chastised by the BJP leadership, that too in public. It's embarrassing. Take a look.
Kisanon ke hitkari bill jo wapas liye gaye the, to pura desh jo hai chauk gaya tha. Ab wo kisan aaj bhi wahan baithe.
The queen of controversy is back. This time, actor and BJP MP Kangana Ranaut has triggered another storm over farmers by advocating for return of three farm laws that were repealed by the center in the aftermath of massive protests.
तो देश के विकास में किसान जो है वो मेन हमारा एक पिलर ऑफ स्ट्रेंथ है. तो मैं चाहती हूँ कि वो खुद ऐसी अपील करें कि भाई हमारे जो थ्री लॉज जो हमसे जो सिर्फ और सिर्फ कुछ एक राज्यों में जो है उन्होंने उसको लेकर जो है आपत्ति जताई थी, मुझे लगता है कि उनको मैं हाथ जोड़ के उनको विनती करती हूँ कि सब किसानों के हित को ध्यान में रखकर जो है वो लॉज जो है वापस मांगे.
बीजेपी वॉज क्विक टू डिस्टेंस इटसेल्फ फ्रॉम कंगना स्टेटमेंट.
ये बयान कंगना रनौत जी का व्यक्तिगत बयान है एवं भारतीय जनता पार्टी की तरफ से ना कंगना रनौत जी ऐसा कोई बयान देने के लिए अधिकृत हैं और ना ही उनका बयान जो पार्टी की सोच है तीन कृषि कानूनों को लेकर उसको दर्शाता है.
The BJP clarification, however, wasn't enough to quell the firestorm. Congress launched a scathing attack, calling Kangana mentally unstable and accusing her of being addicted to controversy.
मेरे को लगता है वो मानसिक रूप से वो परेशान है, मानसिक बीमार है कंगना. और नहीं यार, कुछ लोगों को ना आदतन हो जाती है कि मैंने कंट्रोवर्सी खड़ी करनी है. तो नहीं, बार बार बंदा ऐसा करता नहीं. आप मेरे को लगता है कि उसके ऊपर हमें तरस खाना चाहिए.
बीजेपी की एक सांसद जब ये कहती है, जिन्होंने अभी किसानों को हत्यारा और बलात्कारी बुलाया था और अब वो कह रही है कि कानून वापस आने चाहिए, तो बिल्कुल चिंता होगी, बिल्कुल दुख होगा, क्योंकि बीजेपी का अभी तक कोई अधिकृत बयान नहीं आया है. किसी एक प्रवक्ता ने कुछ बोल दिया, उससे क्या फर्क पड़ता है. बीजेपी के अध्यक्ष जेपी नड्डा जी हैं, वो इस पर बयान दें, स्पष्टीकरण दें, लिख कर दें, बोल कर दें.
NDA allies have also condemned Kangana's remark.
ये कंगना का अपना व्यक्तिगत स्टेटमेंट हो सकता है एंड जरूरी नहीं है कि हर स्टेटमेंट में आप कमेंट करें. ये उनकी अपनी सोच हो सकती है, बट जब तक अधिकृत तौर पर उनकी पार्टी की तरफ से कोई ऐसी बात नहीं आती, मुझे नहीं लगता कि किसी भी हर बयान पे कोई भी टिप्पणी करके उस कॉन्ट्रोवर्सी को बढ़ाने का कोई मकसद है.
उनका ये वक्तव्य किसानों का अपमान है और प्रधानमंत्री द्वारा जो फैसला लिया गया था उसका उल्लंघन है और पार्टी को ऐसे वक्ताओं के लिए संज्ञान भी लेना चाहिए और कुछ कार्रवाई भी करनी चाहिए.
Under fire from all sides, Kangana was forced to retract her statement.
मुझे ये बात भी ध्यान रखनी होगी
कि मैं अब एक कलाकार नहीं भारतीय जनता पार्टी की कार्यकर्ता हूं और मेरे ओपिनियंस अपने नहीं होने चाहिए, वो पार्टी का स्टैंड होना चाहिए। तो अगर मैंने अपने शब्दों से और अपनी सोच से किसी को डिसअपॉइंट किया है, मुझे खेद रहेगा। आई टेक माई वर्ड्स बैक। थैंक यू।
Since being elected MP, Kangna Ranaut has courted controversy at least three times. All three times, she had to climb down and apologize. Will she now be more mindful of her words? Bureau Report, India Today.
And Rahul Gandhi has also opened fire at Kangana Ranaut, the BJP MP. He says, who is deciding the government's policy? Is it a BJP MP or is it the Prime Minister? Listen into what Rahul Gandhi has just said.
ये BJP के जो लोग होते हैं, ये ideas को test करते हैं। ये किसी से कहते हैं कि आप ये idea public में रखिए और फिर reaction देखते हैं। यही हुआ है। उनके एक सांसद ने किसान कानून, जो काले कानून थे, उनको रिवाइव करने की बात की। मोदी जी, आप क्लैरिफाई कीजिए, आप इसके खिलाफ हैं या आप फिर से बदमाशी कर रहे हैं? क्या वो किसान के कानून रिवाइव करेंगे या नहीं? और अगर करेंगे तो फिर मैं आपको गारंटी दे रहा हूं कि इंडिया गठबंधन पूरा इनके खिलाफ खड़ा हो जाएगा। 700 लोग शहीद हुए हैं, उनकी याद करनी है, उनकी रिस्पेक्ट करनी है। मोदी जी ने 2 मिनट मौन नहीं रखने दिया था, हम ये कभी नहीं भूलेंगे।
I want to go across to India Today's Aman Bharadwaj for more on this story. Aman, Kangana Ranaut, not for the first time, has come out and, retracted. She's apologized. But it appears that the BJP has gotten into the habit of pulling her up. And this time they've done it quite publicly as well. What is Kangana planning to do? Is she planning to be careful going forward? Or how is it going to work out? She's not used to being careful with her words.
See, it's not for the first time that Kangana has to be warned with several statements that she made up. In last 30 days, she had made several statements that sparked controversy, whether it was movie Emergency, where she quoted Indira Gandhi and Bhindranwala scene, that also sparked a controversy and protest, and the Sikh communities has to issue a separate press releases against Kangana Ranaut, and that was the reason that Emergency movie was not able to be released for the fixed date, 6 September, after which she made statements that in Delhi protests that held in 2020 for the 11th month, the incidents of rape and murder happened, for which BJP disassociated themselves first from Kangana and had to clarify the statements at several platforms. So it's not the case that Kangana is making such statements for the first time. Even she faced the slap controversy in June here in Chandigarh as well. So it's not for the first time that Kangana has been pulled up by BJP or she has to apologize or her statements been making a controversy. But politically, BJP is preparing themselves for elections in Jammu Kashmir and Haryana. So these sort of statements are affecting their political strategy as well. You see here in Haryana, Khanauri border and Shambhu border, touching the border area of Punjab and Haryana, are witnessing protests from last 10 months. And several farmer leaders are present over there, which are demanding for the justice and for further demands that held, that were promised in 2020 at Delhi protest. So even that are not fulfilled. But when Kangana Ranaut makes such statements that she called Khalistani,
okay,
or she made statements, so that sparks a controversy. But now I have to see, because farm leaders have also demanded that she should be disqualified. Sedition charges should be placed on Kangana. She should be booked.
Let's see whether, the BJP decides that they've had enough and they take even stronger action against Kangana, or whether they're willing to give her a longer rope. It's a sensitive issue. In fact, Aman, thanks very much for joining me earlier. The last time that Kangana had said something that, quote unquote, embarrassed the party on a sensitive issue of farmers and the farm laws, Kangana spoke to me right here at the India Today studios, and I asked her if she feels like she needs to censor herself more now that she's a member of parliament. And just 2 weeks later, she's landed herself in a soup again. Here's what Kangana had told me just a couple of weeks ago. Being a politician, being a new MP is an easy job, Kangana. And even now, Are you feeling like you need to censor yourself? Are you feeling like there are things you can't talk about? You know, your party has just sort of distanced itself from you talking about the farmer protests, which is, you know, I have to say, this is a topic that you've spoken about repeatedly, so obviously it affects you. It comes from within. You've spoken strongly. You've had strong views about it. And it seems like maybe being outspoken, another word that's attached to you all the time, is not suitable in your new role as an MP. Are you feeling the pressure or feeling the heat on that?
I agree with whatever party has said. I'm not the spokesperson for the party that needs to be conveyed, and I am glad that they did. Besides, they have completely disowned my stance to this matter. They have their policies, and I need to be aligned with those policies. And I do trust I do trust in my party, and I do believe that there's nothing more important to me than this party, because, and it's coming from a very genuine place, you know, especially having worked on emergency and to see how they evolved from Jan Sangh to Janata Party, and how even Bharatiya Janata Party is an offshoot of that, and how many people for how many decades have just given their blood and sweat to have this party where it is. And to me, the party matters the most, because that's, of course, my bandwidth is that, and I do believe in them, and to them nation matters the most.
But do you find yourself now having to think about or decide not to say something? The reason I'm saying this, Kangana, and this comes from a genuine place, which is that you've been looked at as a person who speaks her mind. You know, there is no editing, there is no censoring when it comes to Kangana. She speaks her mind, and now suddenly you can't speak about an issue that very many people, and mind you, many people even agreed with what you said about the farm protests, etc. The analogy you may have drawn may have been controversial, but there were people who actually agreed with what you said. So did someone call you and say you can't be speaking like this?
Yeah, of course. Of course I was reprimanded, and that's fine. It's fine with me. I do not think that I am the final voice of the party. I mean, I have to be really crazy and stupid to believe that. And I do believe in the guidance of my superiors. I do believe that's how every system works. That's how army works. That's how corporate works. That's how the party works. You know, there are people who are superior to me. There are people who are free to reprimand me. And there are people who are, without having to explain, to tell me what to do. And I'm okay with that. I do believe that my intentions are obviously, you know, at times my intention may not come across as what it was, but I do have a long way to go, and I do believe that if I've genuinely heard their cause, and I've genuinely heard their position or policies, there is nobody who's going to be more hurt than me. Like, there's nobody I know who will be more hurt than me. So I'm looking forward to be careful with my words and be in aligned with their policies, because for them, Bharat rehna chahiye. Hum rahe na rahe, Bharat rehna chahiye. You know, so that is the larger ambition of the party, and I'm totally aligned with that ambition.